Hey there folks, this is GreenyXI, welcoming you right back to Let's Play Alundra. This is episode 24. In the last episode we went on over to the Fairy Pond and got the Fiend's Blade, which is incredible and we really want to get it for now. This time around we found out from Maya and, well, a few other people that Ronan's been acting weirdly again. So we're going to head on over to see him at the Sanctuary. Make sure you're fully stocked up on items and stuff like that. If it's the part I'm thinking of, then you really do want to be, and it'll be good to have this sword. Hello. Glad you finally made it. Let's go inside. Gentlemen first. Okay, yeah. Gentlemen. Gladio. Who's she trying to compliment? Okay. Hello. Well, Alundra, I see you with Maya today. The statue of Malsus is hidden in the basement of the Sanctuary. I can feel it even standing there. Oh, the gods have shown themselves to you, have they? Well. Yes, Ronan, it was wonderful. They asked me to pray to their visage. Do you think me so dull as to believe you? If you have seen anything at all, it's a devil, not a god. Yeah, Malsus. You want me to take you to the statue I keep, not to worship it, but to destroy it. If you underestimate me, you're likely to be severely disappointed, children. Understood, Ronan. Now get out of my way, and please don't try to prevent the inevitable. Arrogant girl. Beaumont has always known of the statue in my sanctuary. Everyone knows, and they not only approve of it, dear child, they pray to it as well. How would they react, I wonder, if you were to destroy the object of their fevered supplication? I'd wager their reaction to be much less favourable than you would hope, little ones. Be that as it may, this is not over, Ronan, not even close. I will prove to everyone that the statue is the source of the evil, and it will be destroyed. Not the part I was thinking of, but... Those words of blasphemy shall return to consume you, heretic. I love that evil laugh that he does. Okay, so yeah, it wasn't the part I was thinking of, but at least we know that Ronan isn't going to go down lightly. He's not going to get rid of the statue lightly. Ronan is the murderer. I'm sure of it, Alundra. What's more, I believe the next target is someone else near you. We must strive to protect the rest of your friends before he strikes again. I will stay with Septimus. You must watch Jess. We better hurry. Darkness will soon shroud the village. I'll meet you at your house tomorrow morning. Okay. Let's head back to our village then. It seems that Ronan's planning to murder again. Well, we don't know for certain that Ronan is the killer. I don't know. Maybe we'll find out soon. Maybe. You should get some rest. Yeah, okay. Always running around from one place to another, you deserve to relax for one night, my friend. What, me? I cannot sleep yet. I have much work to do. Well, okay. I'll leave you to it. Let's go to sleep. I love how he looks like that, though, when he's on his back. And it looks like he's got one of those sleeping hats on, but it might be like the back of his hair kind of thing, the little ponytail thing he's got going on. Oh, what's he planning? It's time for Jess's shining moment. But what's going to happen? Alundra dreams about what Ronan said as he left the sanctuary, but his exhausted body eventually overcomes his anxious mind. Alundra gently sinks into a deeper slumber, and then, all too soon, the moon and stars surrender the heavens to the morning sun as a cock crows in the distance. I hate it when they say cock instead of cockle. Wake up, Alundra, wake up! It's Jess, he... Uh-oh. What? Breathes not the foul air of this evil world any longer. No! The people of the village have gone to the graveyard. Come with me, Alundra. Alundra is dead. Our father figure is dead. He was one of my favourite characters again, but it looks like he's been murdered. Two of my favourites were murdered. I always hated this part, because I hate when one of my favourite characters gets killed in one of these story-based games. It's the same in, like, Danganronpa, or, I don't know, anything, really. Anything with where the main characters get killed off. Makes me sad. Hello, Ronan. He's doing the ceremony when we think there's him who actually did the killing. Not that many turned up, really. I mean, a lot of the people who are still alive are kids, so maybe they wouldn't, but... you know. Ah. This is going to be quite a long moment. Story-based moment. And it's nice. I think it's nice. I don't mind it being drawn out a little bit. Ah, the kids are you. At least the twins are. I don't have that much to say, really. I mean, it's all on screen, but... it's just horrible, because Jess is the one that finds you at the start after the shipwreck, and brings you into his home, and... I don't know. He's just the friendliest character, no matter what all the other villagers were saying, according to the rumours of Alundra being the instigator of all the nightmares and stuff like that. Jess never believed any of it. He was the kindest person, I would say, in the village. At least to the people that you get to know more. So yeah, I guess this is going to be a story-based episode as well. No fighting, no dungeons, no overworld stuff. Jess found you on the verge of death and nursed you back to health. And how do you repay his kindness, Alundra? You kill him. This is slow talking, it's meant to be. Yes, Alundra. I lay the blame for Jess passing solely on you, murderer. Okay. So he's passing he's passing the blame onto us when we think it's him. Dunno. I dunno. Whenever you come back to the house now, Jess and you is so empty. Take this key, Alundra. I found it clenched in Jess's hand. I have no doubt that his last wish would have been for you to have this. Receive the small key. We're finally gonna get to see what's in the little blue treasure chest. You always wonder, don't you? If you need anything, Alundra, anything at all, I will gladly help you. All you have to do is ask. They always say that to you, don't they? When someone dies, they always say to you, if you ever need any help or anything. Yeah. Anyway, here's what we get. Jess's diary. Alundra. If you were reading this, I must have expired. Oi! This is not good. You know what I'm saying? I went to see what Ronan was doing at the graveyard. While you were sleeping. I know you were suspicious of him, and so was I. But I didn't want you to take him on alone. I'm very scared, Alundra. My hand quivers as I write. I must resist the urge to crumple this note and throw it away. It would be so easy to forget about Ronan, walk upstairs and retire. But I cannot do that, my boy. I consider you as my son, and I do not want you to be ashamed of me. So I have summoned up all the courage I have remaining to write this letter. Great music in the background, by the way. Before I got to Ronan, Alundra, after my wife and son died, I was a broken man. Your iron will and light demeanor have fixed me. I did not know you for long, but I am glad that I did. Thank you, Alundra, my dear son. Love, Jess. Battered broken armor. Okay, that's the main thing we wanted, but it's nice to hear from Jess as well. And now we're going to have a bit where you can't skip any of it. It's just giving you a bit of nostalgia for when he was alive and a bit of memory. Tug at the old heartstrings and all that. You're awake. This is progress. This is good. I was afraid you might be having an eternal rest, you know what I'm saying? My name is Jess. I am a swordsmith here in Anoa. Decent money, make me on hours, no big whoop. What's your name? Alundra, pleased to make your acquaintance, Alundra. You were on board the clock, were you not, Alundra? You're lucky to be alive, you know what I'm saying? They've not found a piece of that ship bigger than my fist. But let's not talk about that. Let's talk about you, my new friend. You're welcome to stay here until you are fully recovered. I live by myself. Once you leave, I'll be a lonely old fat man again. Not that you should feel bad. Only he's not going to be. Can you remember? I want to talk about this while this is going on, because we've seen all this before anyway. Can you remember? In Sybil's dream, when Lutus dies, Jess makes a holy sword out of the memories to give to Alundra to kill off Miles, this kind of thing. But now, Jess is dead, so he's not going to make the sword when Lutus dies. So that was Miles's. I would say that's Ronan's reasoning for killing off Jess. So he can't make the sword. Sorry. Alundra, not too long ago, the people of this land prayed to idols. They were material representations of our gods, you know? But then, quite unexpectedly, the king decreed that all idol worship was forbidden. Exactly, he was worshipping Melzus, for God's sake. The people had no choice but to comply. We watched the destruction of our statues in tears. About that time, the palace in the North Lake was submerged. Sunk, actually. That was 5 years ago, but it feels as if it was just yesterday, you know what I'm saying? Since that time, we've lost the passion to create. What if the gods became angry and took our passion from us? I'm not saying they did, but it certainly makes me think at night, my boy. But gods or no, I must regain my passion, you know what I'm saying? I can almost hear Olin's spirit talking to me, demanding that I make the finest weapons once more. Or even better, demanding I assist in the fight for this land. Yay, bombs! This is the mining bomb. It's actually just a bomb, but since it's used for mining, that's what they call it. Nice way to get through rocks, you know what I'm saying, Alundra? With this, you could easily get into the coal mine, but it's just too dangerous to attempt, my boy. Here's the plan. I go to the mine, I see if it's safe, and maybe I let you go inside. And this is just showing how Jess always protected Alundra. He did it when he was going to see Ronan just now and got killed. You know? Oh dear, Alundra. You're quite late. I was worried. And you're always worried for Alundra as well. Great times. That's always going to show by the looks of it. And this line coming up by you is one of my favourite lines as well. The most horrific day in Alundra's life was finally at an end. As he closed his eyes, he could still see Jess' gentle smile. As this image faded, Alundra silently wept bitter tears of shame and regret. However, even the potent tears failed to wash the pain from his heart. As he implored the gods to stop the madness, he tumbled into restless slumber at last. And there we have it. So, this has been GreenyXI. Hope you've enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you again in a bit when we find out what's coming next. I'm not sure myself, really. In a bit, folks.